Hello, this is a case of ruptured ectopic pregnancy. This patient is a young woman and she has a severe pain. Now, ultrasound has shown right side ruptured ectopic. So we are introducing the varus needle over the inferior crease of umbilicus. So irrigation, suction, and hanging drop test. In the suction, little reddish fluid came out. That was due to the blood collected into the pelvic cavity. Now we start insufflation. Here preset pressure is 15, actual pressure is 7, flow rate is 1 liter per minute, and approximately 1 liter of gas is already in, and it is going correctly. Now incision is enlarged to 11 mm, and then this is the 10 mm trocar will be introduced over the inferior crease of umbilicus. Telescope is inside and we can see the blood. Patient head is down, a steep Tannenberg, so a lot of blood has gone to the upper abdomen, which we will do the lavage, thorough lavage later. But right now the pelvic blood has to be diluted and sucked out to have better vision. The shaking movement of the uterus will start dissolving the clots. And the blood collected from the cul-de-sac has to be taken out. Now this is a striker mini ligated, stretching the left tube, right tube, and then with a atraumatic grasper, antromedial traction is given over the ruptured part of the tube. Here is infundibular ovarian ligament. And keeping the harmonic as near as possible to the tube, the salpingectomy is started from lateral to medial. Salpingectomy is a very easy procedure and it is required in the case of ruptured ectopic. The ectopic was in the ampullary region, so we can see the clot and there is a trophoblast inside, and slowly keeping the harmonic as near as possible to the tube, you can separate it from the major salpinx. Now a striker mini ligator is removed, and then approximately 6 mm of the tube, proximal attached to the uterus, should be coagulated first, so that it should be sealed nicely, and then after coagulating couple of time, then we should cut the tube so that there will be no uteroperitoneal fistula. So 6 mm of the tube should be nicely coagulated by minimum vibration of the harmonic, and then it can be separated easily. It is kept over the anterior cul-de-sac, and now we will use endo bag. This is the endo catch. Commercially available endo bag with a metal ring. This is very good self-retaining endo bag. Now endo bag is opened and then trophoblast with the ectopic is kept inside the endo bag. Now it has a already purse string suture which you can pull outside and endo bag will be automatically closed. Now the mouth of the endobag is taken out with a 10 millimeter cannula, and outside assistant will keep it open, and with the ovum forceps you can crush the trophoblast and deliver the tube and trophoblast out carefully. Once it will be crushed, endobag will be automatically taken out. And here inside the endobag we can see this is ectopic, which is completely taken out, and endobag is nicely stable, not ruptured. After that, irrigation and suction of the upper abdomen. Here we can see subdiaphragmatic area and Morrison's pouch has a lot of blood collected, and that is important to do thorough lavage of the splenic fossa, subdiaphragmatic area, because the blood which is ruptured is collected all over the abdomen and it should not be ignored, otherwise it can create peritonitis and subdiaphragmatic abscess. So all the blood from all over abdomen is sucked out, and repeatedly it was cleaned. This is a splenic area, left lobe of the liver, stomach, falciform, and again subdiaphragmatic and Morrison's pouch. The thorough lavage was performed and entire abdominal cavity was cleaned out. Again going to the pelvis, repeated lavage was performed. Now you can see the fluid is fresh, because almost all the blood is out, and whatever is remaining should be sucked out. So it's now over and the port is closed. So thank you very much for watching this video. This was just a simple case of right side ectopic rupture. Have a nice day.